Baby girl, you've been slaying on our screens for over a decade. What is your secret in staying relevant in this highly competitive industry? I mean, how do you do it?
You need to find and carve your niche.
Okay.
Understand your talent.
Okay.
Harness it. Mm-hmm. You know, try to get better.
Mm-hmm.
And then stay true to your craft. You're only as good as your last job. So people want to, you know, you want to make reference to something that you've done. Oh, Uti, what's your last film? Oh, yeah, I did this film. They go back and they watch it. So you want to make sure that every job you get...
You kill it.
Yeah, you kill it. You bring in your A game and that's it.
Oh, shit. Now, another thing you've been killing on screen is sultry roles. You just seem to slay these roles effortlessly. Like, African Magic's Hush.
Yes.
We cannot forget... your dangerous woman role. I mean, oh my word.
Tisha.
It must have been so much fun playing Tisha.
It was.
What was your favorite part about playing Tisha?
The fact that Tisha was crazy. She was like, like almost like a sociopath.
Cray.
Yeah, she cray cray.
It almost seems like that's like your alter ego that you've been hiding.
Well, you can say that.
You're Sasha Fierce.
No. I'm not that crazy. But you know what? People put me in a box. They tried to put me in a box. The sultry role, oh, the returnee, beautiful daughter of somebody who's rich or whatever. So when I see, when I get a script that is completely different from that, when I have to play a village girl or when I have to play someone like Tisha, it just totally blows me away because it then gives me an opportunity to show my creative prowess, you know, my acting prowess that, okay, yeah, Tana can actually do something different from what you guys are actually always trying to put her in. Mm. So, yeah, I saw Tisha and I read her. I auditioned for her. I put in my best. I was like, yeah, Tisha is someone I want to play.
Nice.
Yeah, she's crazy.
She crazy.
Yeah, she's crazy.
You've stepped behind the camera a couple of times as producer. Very, very bold move.
Mm-hmm.
What are your ups and downs so far?
I would say if you're not ready to produce, don't produce.
Mm.
If you don't have the money to do it, don't do it. Because there are certain things that you can't manage. I learned from the past and I've done two movies again recently. So, yeah, I'd say that's basically what I'm going to tell you. Learn the ropes, understand what you're doing so you can be the best in whatever field you want to.
Okay.